Hello everyone and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, May 11th. My name is Josh Daniel and I'm a Security Program Manager in the Customer Service and Support Organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release and then dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the Security Update Guide. Alright, so let's take a look at the release. This month we have 55 total vulnerabilities being addressed, and that's down from our 13-month running average of 101. When we look at our critical vulnerabilities, we only see 4 being addressed this month. That's again lower than our average of 14. Remote code execution vulnerabilities are also lower this month with only 22, and we usually see about 31. The max at CVSS score, even though we have low number of vulnerabilities, this month we see a 9.9 out of a scale of 10. So certainly that's going to raise some alarm bells, and we'll talk about that one in a moment. The average CVSS score, so the score of all 55 vulnerabilities averaged across, is 7.2, and that's just around our average of 7.24. When we look at publicly disclosed vulnerabilities, we have 3 this month, which is just above our average of 2. And finally, when we look at vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited at the time of the release, this month there are 0, and we're just averaging just under 1. So again, the number of vulnerabilities may be lower than normal, but when we look at the max CVSS score, we see 9.9, another 9.8 vulnerability, and it becomes apparent that just because there's a lower number, that doesn't necessarily lower any kind of risk associated with these vulnerabilities. Because as I mentioned, we have high severity vulnerabilities. So let's start talking about some of those high severity vulnerabilities. Let's start with CVE-2021-31166. This is a remote code vulnerability in the HTTP protocol stack. This is rated at a 9.8 on a scale of 10, so certainly very, very high. As we can see here, the attack vector here is over the network, the complexity is low, and no privileges are required, no user interaction is required. And a lot of times when we see vulnerabilities that are similar to this, where there is no user interaction required, no privileges required, sometimes people might ask the question, is this a vulnerable vulnerability? In this case, the answer is yes. This meets that criteria of a vulnerable vulnerability. Again, no user reaction and privileges are not required. So please prioritize the deployment of this vulnerability. It's available and it affects all the later versions of Windows from Windows 10 up. This is Windows 10 and Windows Server, excuse me. And it doesn't affect the down level versions of Windows, such as Windows 8.1, Server 2012, 2012 R2. So if you have those older operating systems, you're not vulnerable to this. If you have the newer operating systems, unfortunately, you're vulnerable to this, and you need to prioritize patching for this right away if you can. So let's take a look at the next vulnerability we will cover today. This is CVE-2021-28476, and this is another remote code execution vulnerability, this time in Hyper-V. So this is the 9.9 on the scale of 10 vulnerability I mentioned earlier. This is the high point, or the highest rated vulnerability in the set today. And as we look at it, again, we see over the network, attack complexity low. This time privileges are required, low privileges, and user interaction is not required on here again. So that's part of the reason why it's so high. And so this is a guest to host type of issue where a guest VM could force the Hyper-V host's kernel to read from an arbitrary, potentially invalid address. Typically, this would cause, or in most cases, this would cause a denial of service rather than remote code execution. However, it is possible that that memory that is mapped to a device register, you could set it up in such a way where remote code execution could be possible in a more complex scenario. So the attack complexity here, when it lists low, I believe the low is the denial of service. To get to remote code execution requires a little bit more complexity. So that's kind of the good news there, is that the complex part, the really dangerous remote code execution part, is a little bit more difficult to trigger. However, still, the point is here, customers that have Hyper-V installed should be installing the updates as soon as they can. And for this is for all supported versions of Windows, all the way up through the latest versions. So if you have Windows installed in your environment, please take a look at these updates and get them deployed as soon as possible so you can protect yourself from this critical Hyper-V remote code execution vulnerability. All right, so let's take a look at something other than Windows. Let's take a look at a SharePoint server remote code execution vulnerability. This is CVE-2021-28474. And as I mentioned, this remote code execution vulnerability, attack vectors over the network, low complexity, low privileges required, no user interaction is required. And so because there's no user interaction required, that kind of elevates the score up to an 8.8. In this attack, an authenticated attacker could gain access to create a site and could execute code within the SharePoint server. So again, privileges are required. It takes an authenticated attacker, but once inside, they could, as I said, execute code within the SharePoint server. So update here is fairly easy. It's available for SharePoint Server 2019, SharePoint Enterprise Server 2016, and SharePoint Foundation 2013 Service Pack 1. So if you're not on those versions and your question is, well, what about mine? It's not listed. It's likely that you need to upgrade your environment to a supported version of SharePoint, and then once you're on the supported version of SharePoint, then you install the security update. So if you're on an older version of SharePoint, please get your environment updated as soon as you can. Once it's updated to the latest cumulative update, then you can install the security update. All right. And that brings us to a close for today. Just a handful of vulnerabilities. I want to thank you very much for your time. And with that, I will talk to you all next month. Thank you very much.